not, well, it's not political for me because I'm not really a political person, but, and the reason why I talk about the tax rate in that way is because when we raised the tax rate last year by over 2 cents, it was really based on an assessed valuation forecast that was very understated. And that was because we didn't really know what the impact of the revaluation review was going to be. Had we had better data last year when we put the budget together, we would probably not have had to raise the tax rate, or we might have not had to raise it as much as we did. And so this really, if we do end up reducing the tax rate, it would really be to right-size it and to bring it back where it probably should have been years ago. Well, we have a process that we use for letting nonprofit agencies submit a proposal and compete for funding, and that's the process that we've been using for the last few years, and we've continued to use that funding in the current year. We don't anticipate a large increase in the amount of money available for that process, but we always look at the nonprofit funding that we have in the individual departments, and based on service need, we will go ahead and increase funding to meet increases in service demand.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I don't not support that.
Right.
I think if that's something the legislature wanted to do, I think that there's I think there potentially is some value in we've talked about this for a lot of years, the school system having its own taxing authority. And that's I think what you're
exactly.
talking about. And so there would be additional accountability on the part of the school system if they have their own taxing authority.
Thank you.
I can't think of anything that would be specific to ethnic disparities, but they do look at, particularly a lot of focus is on health disparities among neighborhoods, and that's a big focus of the board. Okay, so let me talk a little bit about how school funding works, right? So we have, the state of North Carolina statutorily is required to fund public schools in the state of North Carolina. That's what the state law says. The county funds, we have locally funded teachers, we have locally funded certified staff, and we also provide a supplement to all employees in the county. So that's sort of the structure of how this works. As a general rule, traditionally, the county has not funded teacher raises or raises for state-funded employees. We fund raises for locally funded employees.
We're taxpayers.
No, second. You just have to wait to get back on the
thing. This is not a
dialogue.
I got you, Ms. Johnson. Thank you for that.
Okay. So that's the structure of how it works. The county, we are looking at what's happening at the state level to determine what our funding would be for schools this year. I'm not going to tell you today whether I am or whether I'm not going to fund a supplement, an increase in the supplement for teachers. And that's not a raise. That's an increase in the supplement. So you understand the difference, right?
I do.
Okay. Well, I think it's a joint effort between the county and the state of North Carolina to make the state of North Carolina competitive with other states around the country. So I think that, and this is my personal opinion, this is not the opinion of my board, but I think that the state of North Carolina has not stepped up and has not fulfilled its obligation and its responsibility to educators in the state of North Carolina. So while the county can do what it can, the bottom line is that the state of North Carolina has failed education. And I think that's an important distinction that we have to make. The county will do what we can, but we can't make up for 5 years of the state funding raises for teachers and other certified, and all state employees. You know, we talk about teachers, but there's school bus drivers, there's administrative staff, there's custodians, there's a lot of people that make the schools work. And that those are state-funded employees, and it is a state responsibility, and the county can do what it can, but again, it cannot make up for 5 years of the state not providing raises to its employees. Well, we do budget the cost associated with business investment grants are built into our budget. So, in the event that a company is entitled to get that rebate, we provide that in our budget. Corporations come to North Carolina; they bring employees here. They employ people who are also here. So, it's really a two-pronged approach, right? They do relocate employees, but they also hire local people. But when they do bring employees here and expand here, that does increase the amount of new construction that we get. That increases the tax base. That's good for the county. People come here, they spend money, that increases our sales tax. So that's good for the county. But on the flip side, when you do that, you also have an increase in demand for services, right? So we have to build more schools, we have to hire more employees to provide those services. So it's really a balance, particularly for the county, because the county is the one that provides a lot of those services that are really growth-driven. So you really have to take both of those things into consideration. Well, we traditionally see a lot more growth in the northern part of the county and the southern part of the county, but I think we are starting to see development in the sort of more center city as well, particularly in uptown. We're starting to see a lot more commercial construction. We're seeing right on around the 277 loop, a lot of construction going around there as well. So I think at this point, I think the rebound we're seeing, it's really countywide. Right, and you're talking about capital funding for schools.
Yeah.
Wake County did an $890 million referendum, but their Board of County Commissioners also agreed to raise the tax rate 5 cents to pay for that. And so the county has always sort of tried to take the position that we're going to do as much capital as we can without impacting the tax rate, because that is the feedback that we have gotten from residents when we put referendum on the ballot, that they do not want to see their tax rate go up to pay for construction. Not just school construction, any construction. So we're very mindful of that. Wake County has taken a different position, which has allowed them to do a referendum that's significantly higher than what we did here in Mecklenburg County for schools. Well, we have to go back and look at the data. I don't know that we're... I've heard about that data. I haven't seen that data. That's the MECED data that... Mr. Anderson had and gave that to a lot of people in the county. We have not seen that data. I have not verified that those numbers are correct or not, so as a result, I haven't really responded to that. You're welcome. Right, so with Mecklenburg County, in our budget, we include pay increases for our employees. It's a pay-for-performance system, so it's based on how you perform. There's no across-the-board raises. We will include raises in the county budget for locally funded teachers, and then the raises for state-funded employees are the responsibility right now of the state of North Carolina. That's traditionally how it's been. And so if the rate is going to change in the Board of County Commissioners, we have to make those adjustments in the budget process.